versus zero, so either this is zero or non-zero, so that's why we doesn't use this equation x equals x minus 2 here. Okay. So now we use this equation, this constant equation, that is x2 minus x1 minus 1, that is 0. Okay. So now we get, if x1 equals to half, then if you're putting here the value of x1, we get x2 equals to 3 by 2. Okay. Now we check that our solution is feasible or not. That's why this must satisfy this equality is f1. Okay. So here your equation is x equals to 3 by 2. This is the solution. And x2, okay, so x1 is 1 by 2. X1 is 1 by 2 and x2 is 3 by 2 and lambda is minus 1, mu 0. Okay, so this is your solution. But this solution is, must be satisfied this equality constant. And your equality constant is your what is your f1x? So f1x is x1 plus x2 minus 2. Okay, so if you're putting here x1 plus x2 here, so this becomes okay, so this is less than equals to 0. Okay, so this means this solution. Our solution, this means our x star, that is solution is half 3 by 2. Okay, this vector satisfies our this f1x that is less than equal to 0. Okay, so now this solution is your feasible solution. So now you have to check that or verify, you have to verify this x star, that point is half 3 by 2 transpose point. Is your this is satisfying your critical condition, because you have find this solution from KKT solution. This means this is your KKT condition. Okay, so now you have to verify this and lambda equals lambda star that equals to minus 1 and the mu star that equals to 0. You must have to check that this satisfies this. You have to verify this x star must satisfy the second order sufficient condition. Okay, what is the second order sufficient condition? For that, you have to find the Hessian max of your Lagrangian function. Okay, and that equals to the fx plus lambda hx plus mu gx. Okay, so what is the hx here? So capital hx is the basically the Hessian matrix of this equality constant. What is gx is Hessian matrix of this, and what is fx as Hessian matrix of your objective function. Okay. So now, if we go to the next page, and try to see what is the second order sufficient condition. So, next page. So now, we write here the Hessian matrix of this x star, lambda star, and mu star. Okay, and this equals to the fx star plus the h of star plus mu star gx star. Okay. So now, this term has your usual meaning. And what is your objective function here? What is f0x? So f0x is here, you know that your objective function is x minus 1 whole square plus x2 minus 2. And what is the inequality constant? This is x1 plus x2 minus 2. And what is constant? This is x2 minus x1 minus 1. Okay, from here you can obtain easily what value of fx here. Okay, so if you differentiate partially with respect to x1, so this term is del 2f0 upon x1 square. So if you partially differentiate with x1, this becomes 2x1 2 times x1 minus 1. Okay, and here this term is 0, and then again differentiate becomes only 2 here. Okay, if you differentiate with x1 and then x2, this will, if you differentiate with x2, this becomes only 1, and if x1 is 0, and x2 square, this becomes 1, and 1 differentiated with respect to x2, this is 0. Okay, similarly, if we find to what is the value of gx, so here differentiate this function with respect to x1, so this becomes 1, and then again x1, this becomes 0. Similarly, x2, and then x1 goes to 0, and then x2, then x1 is 0. And if x2, again x2, this is again 0. Okay. And for your hx, so this is a linear function, so you know that because these two are linear functions, so second order derivative is 0, so that's why you obtain this thing. You can differentiate partially with respect to x1 and then x1. The second term is x1, then x2, then here x2, then x1, and here x2, x2. So this means these are all 0. So here you have simply putting these values here. This is 2, 0, 0, 0. And here your lambda star is simply this value is minus 1. Okay. And what is your hx star? So hx star is a matrix that components are 0. And what is the mu star is 0. And here these values are 0, 0, 0, 0. So you can find your Bayesian matrix of your Lagrangian function, that is a 0, 0, 0. Okay, so now for that, this point, that point is your x star, that x star, and that point is x1 is half and x2 is 1, 3 by 2. Okay, so this point, so you have to check that this point is a local minima, because your problem is to minimize that function. Okay, so this means you have to check that this point, this point is your minima. So that's why you have to find the tangent space. Okay, so what is the value of this tangent space? So you know that this is a collection of all y such that your derivative of your equality constant, that is at the star with those y which belongs to, also belongs to that domain where x belongs to. So here x is belongs to R2. So here your x is, x as component are x1 and x2, this belongs to R2. So that's why you here y is also belongs to R2. Okay, so this means this y is belongs to R2. Okay, and derivative of that equals to 0. So you have to find what is the value of this y vector. Okay, so now you know that if we are putting this value here, so this means collection of all y's is the derivative of hx star, and you have already calculated what is the value of hx star. So this value is, okay, so this derivative of that is minus 1 and I think 1, because if you differentiate with respect to x1, this is minus 1 and x2 is 1. Okay, minus 1 and 1, and here your components are y1 and y2, and that equals to 0. Okay, so if you try to solve this equation, so this means this is a minus of y1 plus y2 equals to 0. This means this implies that your y1 and y2 are same, and that is equals to any real number a, and that is not equals to 0. So this becomes to real r. Okay, so this means your current solution is equals to your vector where y1 and y2 both are any real a. In that case, your y vector is a transpose. Okay, where A is belonging to real R. Okay, so if A equals to 0, this is your 0 vector. Otherwise, this is a non-zero vector. Okay, so now you can find the A star. Okay, so now if you are able to find what is your vector Y here, so you get Y is AA transpose. So now you have to check that. So this x star point, because you have calculated this space corresponding to this point, and you have to check that this y, this point is minima or maxima, this depend on the value is y transpose Lagrangian x star lambda star mu star multiplied by y. Okay, if this is greater than 0, this means this is strict minima. Okay, if this is greater or equals to 0, then this is a okay, this is your minima. And if this is less than 0, less or equals to 0, then that case this is your maximum. Okay, so you have to calculate what is the value of this thing. So now this value is y transpose. So y transpose is AA of transpose. Okay, so now if you write to transpose, so this means this transpose sign is disappear. And what is the value of this Lagrangian matrix? You have already calculated the value is 0, 0, 0, 0. And then y vector is column vector. So now this. Okay. if you multiply here, so this becomes 2a, okay, and here if you multiply here, so this becomes a 2a square. So this is 2a square, and this or any a of any a which is a real one, this is always greater or equal to 0. Okay, so any non-zero a, you get this thing is greater than 0. Okay, so this means you find that your this value is greater than 0. So this is your point, that is x star, that comes from your t condition, that this point it satisfies your KKT condition, and this 0, this means your x star point, that is a half and 3/2, this point is a local minimizer. Okay. So local minimizer are strict because this is greater than 0, this is why this is strict local minimizer. So you have to calculate that. Okay. तो ये क्वेश्चन था जो हमने कल हमने ये प्रॉब्लम कराई थी. इसके साथ ही साथ एक में कल और हमने दिया था, जो कल और हमने दिया था और कहा था कि वो आप खुद से कर लें. एंड दैट न्यूमेरिकल इज, और हमने उसमें एक कंडीशन हमने सॉल्व कल कर भी दी. एंड दैट प्रॉब्लम इज यू हैव टू फाइंड मिनिमाइज minimize your objective function, okay, and subject to the constraints, and constraints are x1 plus x2 that are greater or equals to 2, and x2 is greater or equals to x1. Okay, so this is a simple problem, and you have to obtain the value of first of all you have to find the because this is in both cases this is a inequality constants are given, equality constant absent. Okay, so here f1 and f2, this x1 x2 functions are given. Okay, and your x component is nothing. Okay, so this means in your KKT condition, the derivative of objective function, but this lambda because there is no hx function, derivative of hx, okay, plus mu transpose, and this is f1 of x that equals to 0. So here this term is absent due to because there is no hx component, so this equation has no need. Okay, but here your f1, this function, this component has 2, so that's why your derivative of this plus here you can write your component are mu1, mu2, because the mu has of dimension 2, because there are two inequality components. So that's why you can write here f1 and f2. Okay, so this multiplied by the vector is f1 and f2, and that is 0 transpose. This is 0 transpose. Okay, you solve them and try to find the solution, and then you after this solving this condition, you have solution is some x1 value, some x2 value. Okay, so here what is the value of mu, okay, mu1, what is the value of mu2. Okay, so now you have to solve this value, and you have to check that your point is regular or not. Then you have to find the tangent space, and then this point, this is x1 x2, this point is your x, so you have to check that at tangent point you find what is the vector of y, and then check the second order sufficient condition. Okay, and then you finalize the result, that is your minima, and the x star is the local minima. Okay, so ye aap khud se kar le aur ye is more difficult nahi hai. Okay, so now next section is
सर ये जो आपने लिखा है 2a square is greater 0, सर हम लोग जब a हमारा real number में belong कर रहा है तो सर a equal to 0 भी तो ले सकते हैं इसमें,
a equal to 0 भी ले सकते हैं,
तो सर ये 2a square greater equal 0 नहीं लिखते हैं यहाँ पे, सर ये जो आपने लिखा है ना y 2a square greater 0 वाला जो आपने लिखा है ये, तो सर यहाँ पे 2a square greater equal to 0 नहीं लिख सकते हैं,
नहीं लिख सकते हो, लिख सकते हो, लेकिन यहाँ पे क्या होगा ना कि उस केस में आपका जीरो हो जाएगा ना, जीरो वेक्टर हो जाएगा उस केस में। जो ए है दिस ए, यहाँ पे आप लेके चलो ना, आपने यहाँ वेक्टर एक निकाला, आपने एक डिफाइन किया, डेट डॉट प्रोडक्ट ऑफ एनी एनी जीरो और किसी भी वेक्टर के साथ, अगर आप तो ऑलवेज जीरो ही होना है। इस केस में आपको जो वेक्टर निकालना है, दैट इज अ जो नल वेक्टर ना हो। ओके, तो इस केस में आपका वाई वन वाई टू क्या हो जाएगा, इस केस में आपके जो है दैट इज ए। तो यहाँ पे जो ए है दैट इज बिलोंग आर, बट इन केस ऑफ ए इक्वल्स टू जीरो ले लोगे उस केस में, तो ये नल वेक्टर हो गया, कोई मतलब ही नहीं उसका। ठीक है, तो यहाँ
पे
हाँ, तो ए आपने जो निकाल रहे हो दैट बिलोंग्स टू आर, बट ए इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो देयर। ओके, सो दैट्स व्हाई ए वाई जो है दैट ए इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो, बट एनी रियल वैल्यू इन दैट केस, ए इफ ए इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो एंड एनी रियल वैल्यू इन दैट केस दिस इज स्ट्रिक्टली ग्रेटर देन जीरो। ओके ठीक है, क्योंकि ये तो आपका ऑब्वियस हो जाएगा ना कि ये तो यहाँ पे मत आओ, यहाँ पे ये देखो कि तुमने वेक्टर वाई जो लिया टेंजेंट स्पेस में निकाला वो किस सेंस में निकाल लें, तो जो ए पिक्शन आ रही है वही कंडीशन यहाँ पे हम अप्लाई कर लेंगे। ओके, तो यहाँ पे अगर आप देखोगे तो ए को नल वेक्टर ले लें किसी के भी साथ आप लो, तो फिर कोई मतलब ही नहीं रह जाता है। तो जब भी आप हमेशा वाई को जीरो ले लो, इससे करो तो वाई आपका एक नल वेक्टर तो आएगा ही आएगा। ठीक है, तो उस सेंस में तो दैट इक्वल टू जीरो, तो कोई सेंस उसका नहीं है, कोई सेंस उसका नहीं। हाँ, आप उसको कह सकते हो कि ये इफ फॉर नल वेक्टर के लिए दिस इज ग्रेटर आर इक्वल टू जीरो। ओके, तो उस केस में आप ये सकते हो दिस इज योर लोकल मिनिमम। तो ये आप यहाँ पे कंडीशन आप अपने हिसाब से करते हैं। अगर कोई स्टूडेंट अगर ये करता है कि ए इज बिलोंग्स टू आर और नल वेक्टर ले ले, तो उसमें गड़बड़ी नहीं है, कोई गलती नहीं है, अब तब वहाँ पे आप इसको ग्रेटर इक्वल टू जीरो कर दो, लेकिन फिर स्ट्रिक्ट वर्ड हटा दीजिए, आप कहिए कि लोकल मिनिमाइजर है। लेकिन ये आपका एक ऑब्वियस केस दैट इज वाई वन वाई टू, अगर नल वेक्टर ले लें तो ठीक है। तो हम यूजली हम उसको दिखाते हैं, स्टैंडर्ड केस लेते हैं कि हमारा नल वेक्टर अगर नहीं है उस केस में हमारा वाई वेक्टर मेरा जो कि नॉन जीरो वेक्टर हम लेके आएंगे। ठीक है, सो नेक्स्ट पेज, नाउ द नेक्स्ट सेक्शन इज so in this section basically in numerical methods you have already known that some standard methods and how to find the solution of that numerical solution of any problem, and usually in you you have to given a certain algorithm and you have to follow that algorithm and you have to find calculate step by step calculation. Okay, so in an algorithm or iterative algorithm, we start with an initial candidate and that solution is usually known as the initial choice, that is we take x0, okay, and generate sequence of iterates, that is the first iteration is x1, then second x2 and so on. Okay, so for each iteration, so for each iteration, suppose k be the iterations 0 1 2 and so on, the next the next point. So if suppose our initial point is suppose xk, the next point is xk plus 1. Okay, so next iteration is xk plus 1, and this is for k. Okay, so now this next iteration jo hai xk plus 1, this is usually depends on your previous point, that is xk. Okay, and the object function f, and objective function f. Okay, so the algorithm may use only the value of f, this f, at specific points. Okay, so basically the algorithm may use the value of f at specific points or f's its first derivative is f prime. Okay, even we use its second derivative, even its second derivative that is f double prime. Okay, so there are several algorithms are we have to deal in this syllabus. So the several algorithm are the first one is golden section. Second one is Fibonacci method. Third one is bisection method. Fourth one is secant method. And last is Newton's method. And there are here two Newton's method here. First Newton's method for this inequality constants type problem. Okay, and then when we using the equality type of problems, when using gradient and gradient method and other methods, so there is another Newton's method. We have already we will discuss. Okay. So now these are the basics method for that type of problem. There is this method is valid on when the your optimization problem is given and the constants are not given. This means your unconstant optimization type of problem, you can deal type of problem by using such a method. Okay, so in these method, in golden section method, you have uses only only your objective function, that is f. Okay, and in Fibonacci method you have to uses only the objective function, only f. Okay, but this Bayesian and secant method, you have to uses this f and f prime both. Okay, the third derivative and your objective function. In secant method, of course, you have to use a this f and f prime. And I think you do this only f prime here. Okay, so bisection method may if not that function. Okay. So in bisection method and secant method, you have to use only f prime. Okay, so this means you have to use this f prime. Okay, and here in Newton's method, you have uses only f prime and double prime. Okay, so these are the basic concepts for in golden section method and any method. You have to use it at f only. Okay, so today we will try to see these two methods, golden section method and Purkey method. If time permits me, so I will cover these two methods, or otherwise we only go to this golden section method. Okay, so now if we go to the golden section method, so this is a golden section search method or golden section method, both nomenclature is same. So next page so here method first. This golden section and this method says that you have to determine okay, so my notes aapko bhej dun ya aapko chaliye likhta hi hu to determine the minimizer of an objective function suppose the function is from R to R and over a closed interval A, that closed interval is a0 b0. This is your given interval. Okay, and the only property of the function is that we assume of the objective function f is that it is unimodal. Okay, is that it is unimodal means they has only one local minima. Okay, so unimodal which means that f has only one local minimizer. So this is the property of your function. You have to assume that that function has unimodal. Okay, so unimodal means if we take any objective function, suppose that function is unimodal. So if this is the f(x) and this is your f direction, so your function is a unimodal means this type of function here. Okay, this is unimodal, and this means this has only one local minimizer. Okay, and suppose if you have to find this interval, that is a u naught, and suppose this interval is u zero. Okay, so this means you have to find the what is the local minimizer of this function f in a given interval a zero to b zero. Okay, so now here we choose the intermediate points in such a way that the this interval, the range of this is symmetric. Okay, so in that sense, here we choose. So here we choose the intermediate point. Intermediate points in such a way that in of your interval are in the range is symmetric. Okay. This means we have to reduce this range, that is a naught and b naught interval, by this means to take point, that is suppose if we take even point and a2 point like that. So if this is your x star, this point is suppose x star point, and if we reduce that interval, suppose if we take a value, suppose here this value is suppose a1, from this distance and suppose this distance, suppose b1, this point. Okay, so if we take two point in such a manner that the distance of this a0 a1 and b1 b0 is same. Okay, b0 and but are not coincide here. Okay, so you doesn't take the value. Okay, if suppose this a0 point is suppose 0 and this point is 1 here. So if we take the midpoint of a1, okay, so this distance is half and this distance is half. Okay, so is tarah se aapko nahi lena, aapko lena hai aisa ki ye distance jo hai, that is half, say if this is the midpoint a not b not by 2. Okay, so you have to take this value is तो आपको ऐसा लेना है कि ये आपकी हाफ से कम हो और ये दो इंटरवल हैं वो दोनों आपके सेम हो. तो दैट फैक्टर इज इफ वी डिनोटेड बाय दैट फैक्टर इज रो एंड दैट रो इज लेस देन हाफ. ओके, तो हम क्या करें कि इन दैट सेंस द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन ए जीरो माइनस ए नॉट इज इक्वल्स टू बी जीरो माइनस बी वन, and that is some factor, that rho of your given interval is a0 and minus b0. This is the length of that range. Okay, and here what is the value of your rho? Because if you take rho equal to half here, so this means this is the midpoint, so we have to take that rho which is less than half. Okay, strictly less than or equals to minimum, we say chota lena. Okay, so we evaluate f at the intermediate points if the value of this function at intermediate point is less than f of b1, okay, then the minimizer in the range that is a0 and b1, and if this value fa1 greater than or equals to this fb1, then the minimizer that is at the start it located in the range that is a1 e0. Okay, so here we starting with this uncertainty, and we repeat this process, and similarly we find two new process and in each step, and then we using the formula, and we have to obtain what is the value of x star in that. Okay, so if this process आपको numerical solutions में हम जितने iterations sum करते जाएं तो हम उतने close अपने जो हमारा result है उसके हम उतने close हम पहुंचते हैं. So this means इस sense में आप क्या करोगे कि यदि अगर हम इसमें देखें तो यदि हमारे पास हम एक ऐसा फंक्शन ले लें इस तरह से, अगर हमने एक बड़े स्केल पे में ले लिया और सपोज दिस इज योर फंक्शन सपोज लाइक दिस, सपोज इस तरह का कोई हमारा फंक्शन है, ओके, एंड दिस फंक्शन इज डिफाइंड ऑन सपोज द गिवन रेंज इज सपोज दिस पॉइंट इज सपोज ए जीरो एंड हियर दिस पॉइंट इज सपोज बी जीरो, ओके, एंड दिस इज योर x स्टार. Okay, so you know that this is your local minimizer. So first of all, we have to find out this is the value of a1 and equidistance you have. Okay, and if the functional value here, this is the functional value of, and this is the functional value of f of b1. Okay, if of your functional value at this intermediate point a1, so if fa1 is less than fb1, so this condition hold, if fa1 is less than b1, then your next interval is a0 to b1. Okay, so this means aapka jo local minimizer hai wo a0 aur b1 ke beech mein hoga, okay, na ki is side hoga. So this means aapka jo pehla step mein jo interval tha that is a0 b0, ये रिड्यूस हो गया किसमें, दैट इज ए जीरो एंड बी वन. ओके, सो नाउ यू दिस थिंग, ओके, देन यू हैव टू नाउ लोकेट टू न्यू पॉइंट बिकॉज दिस इज न्यू इंटरवल ए जीरो बी वन. सो नाउ यू हैव डिवाइड दिस इन सच अ मैनर, दिस पॉइंट इज ए टू एंड हियर यू टेक दिस पॉइंट बी टू. ओके, दिस इज टेक एज बी टू. And now you have to obtain what is the value of function value of fa2 and this is fa2. Okay, so now this a1 point is now reduced to in the form of b2, and you have to calculate that value. Okay, and if this value is less than, then your local minimizer is lies between these two interval, and that interval are a0 and b2. Okay, and this b2 is something your previous point that is your a1. Now, in such a manner, you have to relocate this interval, and size is reduces, and for more iterations do now closer to this point x star. Okay, so now we have to find what is the value of that row, because this row is less than half, but what are the exactly value of this row? Okay, so now we have to calculate this row by using the basic rules of this golden section search method and try to find what is the value of row here. Okay, so now next page. So which is starting with the reduced range. Of uncertainty we repeat the process and similarly find two new points and if we take that point as A2 and E2, so now we using the same value of our row, that is half as before. Okay, so x star is now belongs to the interval A0 B1. Okay, so we have to find the value of row that results in only a new only one new solution or new evaluation of F. Okay, so now without loss of generality, if we have imagined that original range is A0, B0. Suppose if this interval...
Sir, without ke baad kya likhe aap?
Without loss of generality, imagine that the original range is A0, B0, is of unit length. Okay, so hum जो इंटरवल है उसको हम यूनिट लेंथ ले लें और देन वी विल डू द कैलकुलेशंस. ओके, सो देन वी हैव ओनली वन न्यू इवेल्युएशन ऑफ एफ. So it is enough to choose our row so that this thing. So here your interval suppose this is your A0 and B0 of unit length. Okay, so now in first iteration, so you find out these two values, that is your points A1 and B1, and this distance of this is rho, and of course this distance is rho, and this is a unit length. So this is a unit length, that's why this distance is 1 minus 2 rho. Okay, so this distance is 1 minus 2 rho, because we take here this interval is length of that interval is 1. Okay, so if this is rho, which is less than half, and here you take, okay, so this distance is 1 minus 2 rho. Okay, minimizer is like in this interval, that is A0 and B1, then next point is this interval is reduces to that interval, and that point is A0, and next point is this we taken here, because our minimizer is located here, because f of A1 is less than this thing. We take either this or this, so let us take this interval. So in this case, this point is now, if take this value, and here what is the value of this interval here? This is B0 minus A0, that is of unit length, so we can write here that equals to 1. Okay, and this distance is rho. Rho, this means this distance, if we take here this to this, this becomes 1 minus rho at that point, because this total length is rho, so this is total length is 1. If we take this is value is rho, this is 1 minus rho. Okay, so these are the values of your intervals. Okay, so now here if we take the second interval, and that is if we take the next point is here this point is, if we take this point is A here. Okay, so because the new point is A0 and this is B1. Okay, so you take this is your interval A0 and B1. Okay, so this point is B1. So suppose A0 and B1. So okay, so point is A0 and B1. So now in this interval you have to take two new points, and that are your A2 and B2. So what is A2 and B2? And here you have only one new evaluation. That's why you have to take this B1, this end points. Okay, this point B1 is taken as in next interval, that is this point is A2, and here this point is A2. So here to take this point is A2 here. Okay, so now if we take this is A2 and this point is remain there, this A1 point. Okay, and this A1 point we located, this point is as B2. Okay, and this is your interval A0 to B1. You take this interval, and here this A1 point is as your new interval, that is B2, and this new point you have to obtain, and that point is A2 in second iterations. Okay, and so on, you have to calculate all these values. Okay, so now what happened when we take these values here? So you know that this interval, that is a B1 minus B2, this thing, B1 minus B2, or B2 is same as B1. So this equals to rho times this B1 minus A0. Okay. And here your value of B1 minus A0 is 1 minus row and b1 minus b2, this value is 1 minus 2 row. Okay, so then if we're using this condition, so 1 minus 2 row is equals to row times 1 minus row. So this is a quadratic equation of row. So this becomes this thing equals to 0. So this means you have obtained the value of row is equals to, this is 3 plus minus root over 5 over 2. Okay, so because we take rho is less than 2, so we require that our rho is less than half. Okay, so this rho is less than half. We take this rho equals to this 3 minus 5, because if you using plus sign, so this 3 plus and 5 means 2 plus something, to 2 plus 3, 5, 5 upon 2, this is more than, this is greater than half. So that's why we take the sign. Okay, and if we solving this value, this equals to 0.38197. And what is the value of 1 minus rho? So this is approximate equals to 0.61803. Okay, so this implies this. Okay, so if we try to find what is the value of this rho upon 1 minus rho, so this equals to 1 minus rho upon 1. Okay, so if we try to find this value is 1 minus rho, so this equals to 3 minus root 5 upon root 5 minus 1. So this equals to root 5 minus 1 upon 2. So this is 1 minus rho upon 8. So this means you obtain this rho upon 1 minus rho, that equals to 1 minus rho by 1. Okay. So thus dividing a range in ratio of rho to 1 minus rho has the effect the ratio of the shorter segment to the longer equals to the ratio of the longer to the sum of the two. Okay, this means that sum of the two means that equals to 1. Okay, so this means you can write here, thus dividing a range in the ratio of rho to 1 minus rho, आप इसको इस तरह से कर रहे हो कि एक रो होगा, दूसरा 1 minus rho होगा, as the effect the ratio of the shorter segment to the longer segment, to the longer segment, that equals to ratio of the longer to the sum of two, to the sum of the two. Okay, the sum of the two is 1 minus rho plus rho, that equals to 1. So this sum of two, that equals to 1. Okay, so now which one is shorter here? So if you this is a 0 and b 0, and if we take this is your a 1 and this is b 1, and this value is of course rho, so this value is 1 minus rho here. Okay, so this is rho is your shorter, because because here rho is this value is this segment is your longer segment because 1 minus rho value is here this is 0.62 and what is the value of rho is 0.38 okay so approximate you take this is approx 38 and this if this is 0 this is 1 so this a1 is 0.38 and this value a1 to b0 that value is 0.62 okay so now using the golden section rule means that every state of uncertainty range the objective function need only be evaluated at new point okay सिर्फ हमें हर स्टेप में हमें एक ही न्यू पॉइंट पे हमें चेक करना है और ये जो पुराना पॉइंट है फर्स्ट स्टेप में अगर मैं बात करूं ओरिजिन हमारा रेड कलर में दिया हुआ है दैट इज गिवन इन रेड कलर ए नॉट बी नॉट फर्स्ट इंटरवल देन वी हैव टू कैलकुलेटेड दिस ब्लू पॉइंट दिस इज फर्स्ट स्टेप में हमें सिर्फ दो नए पॉइंट्स पे हमें वैल्यूज फाइंड करनी है और बाकी सारे इटरेशंस में हमें सिर्फ और सिर्फ एक ही न्यू पॉइंट्स हमें अपने फंक्शन की वैल्यू में फाइंड तो फर्स्ट स्टेप में जहां हम लूप पॉइंट की बात करें वहां पे हमें जो है a1 की वैल्यूज निकालनी है फंक्शन की वैल्यू f(a1) और f(b1) पर भी निकालनी है सिर्फ फर्स्ट स्टेप में बाकी इसके बाद सेकंड फोर्थ एंड nth स्टेप्स इटरेशंस में हमें सिर्फ एक ही न्यू पॉइंट एग्जांपल अगर हम लूप पे हमने निकाल रखा है तो नेक्स्ट मेरा इंटरवल का दैट इज a0 टू b1 तो इस a0 b1 में हमारा जो पुराना पॉइंट है दैट a1 this depends on this new interval jo hamare that is a2 two points honge a2 and b2 a2 aur b2 ye depend karenge hamare ye dono points hamare a2 b2 ki ye a1 ko hame kya assign karna hai either a2 or b2 this depends on ye point jo hamara closer kis side ke hai kyunki aapko malum hai ki hamara ye dono point jo bhi points honge that is mid point se chote honge तो आइदर ये मिड पॉइंट का यहाँ है तो आपको ये देखना होगा कि दिस A1 पॉइंट आपके जो न्यू इंटरवल है दैट इज A0 B1 A1 पॉइंट इज क्लोजर टू व्हिच पॉइंट A1 इज क्लोजर टू A0 और A1 इज क्लोजर टू B1 अगर आप ये देख लें कि A1 मेरा पॉइंट जो है दैट इज क्लोजर टू A0 अगर ये इसके क्लोजर में है तो दिस मींस यू इस पॉइंट को आपको A2 असाइन करना होगा एंड यू हैव टू टेल find new point that is B2 and if this A1 point is closer to B1 then this right hand side point to assign B2 and you have to find new point that is A2 okay so is tarah se aapko ye sari cheeze karni hai so now next page So using golden section rule, means that at every stage uncertainty range reduction except the first क्योंकि ये भी बताया कि first में हमें सिर्फ दो point निकालना है तो except the first state first the objective function f objective function f need only be evaluated at new point and your uncertainty range is reduced by the ratio in each step your range is reduced by the factor 1 minus rho. What is the value of 1 minus rho is? So 1 minus rho is 1.61803. Okay, at every stage. So at every stage. Okay. So up as a dekhte ho ki jo hamara first A0 B1 hai, and that is your A1 and B1, distance is rho and this distance is 1 minus rho. Okay, so you take this interval. This interval means this value is 1 minus rho and this is rho. Your size is reduced by a factor 1 minus rho here. Okay, rho size jo hai, ye aap chhod de rahe. And you have to maintain this 1 minus rho. Okay, so in each step, your fraction size is 1 minus rho, that is a 0.62. Okay, so now if we taking any step, so hence n steps of reduction using the golden section method reduces the range and by the factor that is 1 minus rho to power n. Okay, or you can say that it is a 0.61803 power n. After n step, your interval size happens to that factor. Okay, so this is the theoretical part of this golden section search method or golden section. Okay, so now we take example and try to calculate the, what is the this is a golden section search tool. So by using golden section method find the value of x minimize option. Suppose if we take x to the power 4 minus 14 x cube plus 60 x square minus 70 x. Suppose this is your function, in which is the interval and if interval is 0 to 2. Okay, so you have to find what is the local minimizer of what is the minimum value of this function within the range this 0 to 2, and you have to find you have to do your calculation in which step when you this interval reduces to in what size, that is 0.3. okay, so if you got that interval, so this means your local minimizer must be lies in that interval with the range of 0.3. okay, so now for that let's start with some iterations. So we have to find which number of iterations we have to do. So for that, we have to calculate what is the value of n stays here. Okay, so you know that after we doing n stages, so after n stages, the range, and that original range is 0 to 2. Okay, this is ruled by a factor, this is this reduced by factor, and that factor is 0.61803 to the power n. Okay, so we choose n, so that we have to find out what is the number of stages here. Okay, so you know that after n stages, this value that you reduce your size, okay, that is less or equals to this 0.3. okay, so your 0.3 of original interval is 2 minus 0. This is the length of interval. Okay, so you reduce in this interval, and your original length is 0.2. okay, so after solving this, what is the value of n here? So we get here this n equals to 4. Okay, so on solving this, you get n equals to 4. So this means you have to, after 4 stages of reduction, will do. Okay, so after 4 stages, to get the interval, and that interval is within the range of 0.3. But what is that interval? Okay, तो वो interval होगा क्या? ये तो आप यहाँ से निकाल लीजिए कि 4 stages में interval मिलेगा, जो कि जिसकी length जो है वो 0.3 से ये या तो equal होगी, और हमें उसी range में हमें चाहिए. Okay, इसके लिए आपको 4 stages आपको करने होंगे. Okay, but वो interval होगा क्या? वो interval 0 to 2 जो given interval है, उस interval में 0.3 interval का कहीं पर भी वो हो सकता है, 0.3 range का, that is 0.3 range का, वो आपका interval कहीं भी यहाँ हो सकता है. And what is that interval? What is the value of in point this, and what is the value in point right hand side there? Okay, you have to calculate it by using old search method. Okay, so now for that, we do 4 iterations here. Okay, so now in iteration first, okay, so we evaluate f at 2 immediate points. और आपको ये मालूम है, you know, in first step you have to calculate the functional value at 2 points, and after first iteration you have to only calculate it at 1 point. Okay, so we have this a1. Our formula is very simple. This a1, the new point of a1 क्या होगा? So this original AZ point plus root times the length of that interval as a0, b0. So your original a0 point is 0, plus what is the value of our rho, that is 0.38197, and what is the length of that, that is 2 minus 0. If you calculated that value, this is 0.7639. Okay, so this is the value of a1 here. So what about b1 point? The b1 point is, the formula is a0 plus 1 minus rho times the length of your interval, which is b0 minus a0. So the b0 is, this equals to 1.236. Okay, so you get what is the value of a1, b1. So now you calculate what is the functional value of, okay, the functional value means your function is this thing. This means you have to calculate the value of 0.67639 to the power 4 minus 14, 0.639 to the power 3 plus 60, then 0.639 to the square minus 70 into 0.6339, and after calculating this you get minus 24.36. Okay, similarly if we calculate the value of functional value at V1 point, that where in this function, so you get this value is minus 13.96. okay, so which one is minimum here? Okay, so which one is minimum? So you see that from these two, f of A1 is less than f of E1. Okay, so this means your functional value, if this is your interval, that is A0 and B0, and two are the points, that is A1 and B1, and the functional value is f A1 is less than f of B1, this means your new interval. So now your uncertainty interval is reduced to this much. Okay, so thus so the uncertainty range interval is reduced to interval is A0, B1. So what is the value of A0? A0 is 0. What is the value of B1 is 1.236. This means your local minimizer is lies between 0 and 1.236. Okay, this is your 0, this is your 2. So this is reduced to this value, this is 1.236. Okay, so this means 0.6 times this is okay. So this is your new interval. Now you calculate the next step. So now we go to iteration second. The next page. So now iteration 2. So now this is your interval, and interval is A0, and this is your B1 point. Okay, so now you have to calculate a new iteration, because this is iteration 2, so your new points are A2 and B2. Okay, and now you see that you have already calculated what is the value of A1 here. So A1, in your previous page, I have discussed what is the A0, B1, and here is A1 point. Okay, and that A1 point value is 0.76, and this value is 1.236. Okay, so approximately 1.2 something. So this is A0 point. But A1 point kya tha? A1 point hamara tha, that value is 0.7. Okay, so mid point iska kya hoga? Aap isko bas aise dekh le, iska jo interval liya hai aapne, uska mid point kya hai? That is 0 hai, aur ye kya hai mera 1.2 hai. So approx 0.6 ke aas pass iska kya hoga? Mera mid point hoga. Yahan kahin mera iska point, this point is 0.6. Okay, 0.6. But your A1 point, jo ki abhi pichla aapne calculate kiya hai, that A1 point is 0.76. So 0.76, this means that A1 point is lies here. Okay, so here you point A1, and that A1 point is 0.7639. ओके तो दिस पॉइंट इज ओके. अब आपको क्या करना कि इसमें आपने देख लिया कि मीड पॉइंट के ये राइट हैंड साइड में वन पॉइंट है, मीड पॉइंट के राइट हैंड साइड में पॉइंट है, दिस मींस इस पॉइंट को आपको कंसीडर करना है. तो अगर ये राइट साइड में है, मीड पॉइंट के राइट साइड है, दिस इज क्लोजर टू दिस बी वन, तो इस पॉइंट को आप लोकेट किससे कर लोगे, आप बी टू से कर लोगे. अगर सपोज इसकी वैल्यू 0.7 ना होकर सपोज 0.4 होती, 0.4 होती तो ये पॉइंट कहाँ, इस साइड में आता, इस साइड में आता, तो ये क्लोजर टू किसके होता, ए जीरो में, दिस मींस ये लेफ्ट साइड का पॉइंट हो जाता, तो उसको आप ए टू से, इसको आप ए टू से डिजाइन कर लेते. तो नाउ अब यू हैव टू फाइंड अ न्यू पॉइंट दैट इज ए टू पॉइंट. अब ये ए टू पॉइंट क्या होगा ये हमें नहीं मालूम, तो हमें सिर्फ ए टू निकालना है और बी टू जो है वो पिछले केस इटरेशन लेंगे और दैट इज योर ए वन. व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ ए टू, तो वी चूज choose B2, this point B2, this coincide with A1. So this B2 coincide with previous point that is A1, and so F need only be evaluated at one new point, at one new point, that is, that point is A2. What is the value of A2 here? So, since this is a left hand side point, so A2 point is your initial point plus rho times the length of interval. And so length of interval is B1 minus A0, because this is the length of new interval is B1 minus A0. Here, this A0 is 0 plus what is the value of rho is 0.38197, and length of B1 value is 1.236 minus 0. So you calculate that value is 0.4721. So this is your A2. So now we have to calculate the functional value at this point A2. If you calculate this value, suppose this value is this thing. Okay. And what is the value of f of A2? हमने निकाल लिया f of B2. F of B2 as it is हम लेके आ रहे हैं. तो हमने previous iteration से that A same होगी and that value is -24.36. Okay, so now your f of b2 is less than f of a2, so the uncertain range or interval, uncertainty इंटरवल रेंज की बात करेंगे तो हमें उसका सब्ट्रैक्ट करके लिखना होगा b माइनस a की वैल्यू. सो इंटरवल इज रिड्यूस इन इंटरवल जो है वो रिड्यूस होगा टू a. सो f b2 हमारा क्या है लेस देन है, f b2 मेरा क्या है लेस देन है, दिस मींस हमारा जो इंटरवल होगा दैट इज a2 और b1 के बीच में होगा, क्योंकि यहां दिस मींस a2 and B1. So this is A2 and B1. What is the value of A2 B1? So A2 value is here, now calculated, this value is 0.4721, and what about B1 is 1.236. Okay, value. So now we go to iteration third. Now, in iteration third, our interval is, new interval is A2 and here B1, and what about A2 point is 0.471 and this point is 1.236. Okay, so A ले लिया, B2 ले लिया और ये जो B2 point था हमारा that is 0.7. Okay, अब इसका देख लें कि ये मेरा लगभग पॉइंट सेवन जो है वो किस साइड आएगा, कि किसके पास होगा। तो हम अगर ये देखें तो इन दोनों का मीट पॉइंट क्या होगा, दैट इज 1.2 है और ये 0.47 है। तो 0.47 अगर आप इसमें से माइनस करते हो तो दिस बिकम्स, अगर इसको हम 4 भी माने तो 4, ओके, सो दिस बिकम्स अप्रॉक्स 0.8 के आसपास हमारा जो है कहीं मीट पॉइंट आएगा। और ये जो है हमारा पॉइंट 0.7 है, तो दिस मीन्स ये V2 पॉइंट दैट इज मीट पॉइंट के इस साइड आ जाएंगे। सपोज दिस इज योर मीट पॉइंट, तो यहाँ पे हमारा पॉइंट आ रहा है, दैट पॉइंट इज V2, ओके, दिस पॉइंट इज V2 एंड विच वैल्यूज इज 0.76, ओके। तो दिस मीन्स ये लेफ्ट हैंड साइड में है, तो यू असाइन दिस पॉइंट एज A3, ओके, एंड देन यू फाइंड हियर यू पॉइंट B3, ये आपको निकालना होगा, तो राइट हैंड साइड के पॉइंट आपको निकालने होंगे, ओके। सो नाउ वी सेट इन थर्ड, तो वी सेट हियर दिस A3 दैट इक्वल्स टू B2 एंड नाउ वी हैव टू कंप्यूट दिस B पॉइंट, ओके। सो B3 इज इनिशियल पॉइंट दैट इज A2 प्लस, ये राइट हैंड के पॉइंट है तो हमें 1 माइनस रो से मल्टीप्लाई करना होगा, और अगर वो लेफ्ट हैंड के साइड होंगे तो आपको रो से मल्टीप्लाई करना होगा, दिस 1 माइनस रो एंड द लेंथ ऑफ दैट इंटर एंड लेंथ इज B1 माइनस A2, ओके। सो नाउ व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ A2 इज 0.4721 प्लस 1 माइनस रो इज 0.618 03 and B1 minus 1.236 minus 0.4721 and the point is equals to 9443. Okay, so this is the value of B3 point. Okay, so you have to calculate what is the functional value at B3. So B3 value is equals to minus 24.59. And what is the functional value of A3? So A3 is, you set this functional value of B2, and already you know that what is the B2 value is minus 24.36. Okay, so now in sense, in this case, your f of A3 is less than f of B3. Okay, so f of A3 is at this point, f of A3 is less than this thing, this minimizer lies between A2 and B3. Okay, so this means your uncertainty. So, in the interval, ye ho jayenge aapke A2 B3. Okay, A2 B3 ka sense kya hai? That value is 0.4721 and 0.9443. Okay, so now we go to the last iteration, that is iteration 4. This is iteration 4. Okay, so in iteration 4, ab hum dekhe iteration 4 mein kya hoga? So, hamara jo ye interval hai, that interval is now A2 point here and this point is B3. What is the value of A2 is 0.4721. This is 0.9443. Okay, mid point iska jo hoga ye hai lagbhag hum kar le 0.7 ke aas paas kahin iska mid point hona chahiye, aur hamara jo ye point hai that is this point is okay. So this point is 0.76. ठीक, तो हम क्या करें कि हमारा जो ये जो पॉइंट है A3 पॉइंट है यहाँ से, ओके, A3 पॉइंट, तो A3 पॉइंट इज क्लोजर टू व्हाट, A3 पॉइंट जो है बिकॉज इसका मिड पॉइंट करीब 0.7 है, और एबी पॉइंट की जो वैल्यू है दैट एथ्री पॉइंट इज 0.76 ओके जो तो करीब यहाँ है ओके दिस पॉइंट इज एथ्री दिस पॉइंट इज एथ्री ओके इसकी वैल्यू क्या है 0.7639 ओके तो दिस मीन्स ये जो है मिड पॉइंट के राइट हैंड साइड में है दिस मीन्स यू सेट दिस पॉइंट एज फोर्थ स्टेप दैट इज बी फोर सो आपको राइट साइड का पॉइंट ए फोर आपको क्या करना होगा कैलकुलेट करना होगा ए फोर आपको कैलकुलेट करना होगा दिस मीन्स इन दिस केस यू टू सेट जो बी फोर पॉइंट एज ए थ्री एंड यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट वट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ ए फोर ए फोर की वैल्यू क्या होगी इनिशियल पॉइंट दैट इज ए टू प्लस जो कि ए है तो रो टाइम्स करेंगे लेंथ ऑफ दैट इंटरवल इज बी थ्री माइनस ए टू So if you calculate this value is 0.6525 okay so you have to calculate what is the function value at that point so you, if you calculate this value this thing what is the value of b4 same hoga a3 ka aur a3 kya hai mera same hai minus 20 ye hamara shuru se aata ja raha hai pichle step se ओके तो इससे आपने कैलकुलेट कर लिया तो यहाँ से आपने देखा कि एफ बी फोर जो है दैट इज लेस देन वैल्यू ऑफ ए फोर ओके सो दिस में यू से दैट दिस वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स दैट मिनिमाइज एफ इज लोकेटेड located in interval in the interval that interval because this a4 mera chota hai b4 chota hai this means aapka jo naya interval hoga wo kya hoga a4 b3 okay so this is interval that is a4 b3 the, what is the value of that interval is 0.6525 and this is 0.9448 okay so this fourth step mein kyun aa gaya kyunki ab agar aap kahe what is the range of that interval the range is 4 minus a3 okay so if you calculate the range so that is 0.292 okay this is less than 0.3 so this means you got the answer your local minimizer lies in this interval or this interval and this range of that interval is less than 0.3 okay so that's why you have to calculate your variations at four steps you got this result okay but you don't know what is the interval so that's why you can calculate and have to solve that problem and finally you get this interval And in this interval, the local minimizer exists of that objective function of given f(x). Okay, and what is the exact value of that minimizer? Okay. That's why exact value. अगर आपको चाहिए, तो आप iterations 4 के बाद आप उसको और refine करते जाओ 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, तो आप धीरे धीरे closer to minimizer चले जाएंगे. Okay, तो आप वैसे भी देख सकते हो या आप कहीं से हमने सिंपल फंक्शन लिया है आप उस फंक्शन को क्या करो कि सिंपल फंक्शन को आप डिफरेंशिएट कर लो ओके एंड यू नो दैट हाउ टू फाइंड द लोकल मिनिमा सो इफ यू डिफरेंशिएटिंग दैट फोर्थ ऑर्डर जो पॉलीनोमियल यू गेट द थर्ड ऑर्डर 3 इक्वेशन को मिल जाएंगे दैट इक्वल्स टू 0 सो नाउ यू पुट f(x) इक्वल्स टू 0 एंड देन find the double derivative and putting that value of x your sine of that is greater than 0 this means that value of x is minimizer okay to aap us tarah se aap nikal sakte ho aur wo dekh sakte ho minimizer hai ya aap khud se kariye ki usko aap usual get standard maximum minimum aapne jo function ka padha hai वहां से आप f(x) निकालो जीरो करो डबल डेरिवेटिव निकालो उस पॉइंट करो तो देखो कि उसकी वैल्यू मेरी जीरो आ रही है तो आएगी और वो जो वैल्यू x है वो देखिएगा इसी के बीच में होगा ओके तो हमने इसलिए सिंपल प्रॉब्लम कराया कि आप उसको चेक अपनी मैथमेटिक्स से आप वो करो और वहां से आप चेक भी कर सकते हो और वहां से आपको ये विजुलाइज हो जाए ओके तो ये पूरा है आपका होल्डिंग सेक्शन मेथड देन नेक्स्ट मेथड इज फिबोनाची ओके, काफी हो गया, आप थक भी गए होंगे, तो
थैंक यू सर।